minutes to go back there and make sure the bastard's dead. Move, Lieutenant Baird.
Denied any right to an attorney and may not question the authority of this tribunal.
So we can't ask why you're doing this now.
At the conclusion of this tribunal, I will issue a fair and swift verdict.
Right. Of course you will.
Colonel, are we being charged with doing our job?
The charges will be defined as I hear your testimony. Now, Lieutenant Baird, begin with the last time we saw each other.
Our mission was to rendezvous with a supply convoy. But then, things started to go wrong.
How exactly did things go wrong, Lieutenant?
Gradually, sir. And then, suddenly. Whatever it was, it looked like it was headed right for our convoy. Only Paddock knew what he was looking at. But he didn't say anything. Not yet. Began, our cities have been falling one by one, and command has no idea who or what's responsible. Well, Colonel, I think I might know.
For me.
We went as fast as we could, sir. There was no saving that convoy. I'd heard other units talk about the glowing wretches, but I thought that was just soldiers telling stories. Turns out it's not. Our old convoy had been wiped out. In minutes. Never seen anything like it.
We have to find whatever did this.
Wretches died. They exploded like they'd been drinking out of a fuel tank. I hoped we wouldn't be seeing them again anytime soon.
Colonel Loomis, this is Lieutenant Baird. Big problem, sir. Our convoy just got destroyed.
Then move on to the Museum of Military Glory. It's under attack.
Sir, whatever destroyed our convoy is still out there.
Noted, Lieutenant.
Yes, sir. Come on, Kilo. You heard the man.
I heard him. Doesn't mean I like him.
The museum was on the other side of the river, the side the cog no longer controlled. I thought maybe we could slip through unnoticed.
Yeah, nice. Kind of reminds me of my old wine cellar.
Wait a minute. You have a wine cellar?
Hey, look, a man gotta spend his money on something.
So this is the UIR sniper rifle.
This isn't a gun! It's a comrade! need is my hands! Bring them on!
You know, it's almost like they don't want us to get to the museum.
I knew we would save time by going through some buildings. It's not like there were any civilians left to care. I was beginning to figure out that the Old Town civilians were the least of the cog's worries. I know we're forbidden from using enemy weapons, Colonel, but to survive out there in the field, you have to know how to adapt, and I'm an adaptable man.
We got a healing canthus! Hit it! These grunts seem awfully interested in your idea!
Yeah.
Is that all of them?
Yeah, I doubt it.
Reach the surface!
Never seen so many grubs in one place before.
I know. Let's just get inside. Sent us. Where should we go?
You're not Onyx.
I'm Onyx.
No, you're not, Cadet. Stay here and defend this area. The East Wing is getting hammered.
We're the first line of defense for the Onyx Guard. Let's show them what regular soldiers can do, Kilo.
Here's a souvenir.
Keep them back, Onyx! Keep them back! Hey, they're on the move! Where are you? Left side! Left side! The party got cracked up!
Nice work! If it grunts, it does!
Hey, here's a souvenir.
More for me.
Thank you.
this position until they stop coming.
Hey, status report. Teagle, can you see Hayes' squad?
Bring it up, they're banging us up. We can't see anything.
We're pulling back. Who's still with me? Teagle, can you cover? Where are those reinforcements?
Boomers!
If we don't hurry, they're not going to make it!
Black Force said they were losing the East Wing. He didn't mention they lost everything on the way there.
Hey!
gun!
We hadn't heard anything else from Black Four, so we were going to find either bodies or a battle, or an ambush.
Whoever's coming through that door isn't selling insurance! Get ready, Kilo!
For weapons in case they keep coming.
Ah!
that feeling.
What the hell is that?
That's the end of Halvo Bay.
There's only one way out of here.
Two, actually. One involves dying.
Got him.
We were all a little shaken up. That grub was upsetting in 12 different ways. It was time to talk to Paddock.
Did you recognize that thing, Paddock?
Unfortunately, yes.
Some grubs lay eggs, and not the kind you can fry. We decided to destroy every clutch we could find.
They look vulnerable back there.
Centipede!
Something tells me we should make sure we get all those eggs.
Splatter!
Litter splatter.
Man, I thought the grubs walked around on two legs like normal people. Can we go now? Please?
Regular grubs weren't upsetting enough. Everyone okay?
Grubs made an exit for us.
Enough eggs. I prefer to shoot at something that walked around on 2 feet for a while.
What have they done to my marks, sir?
A sniper rifle with no scope! Ha! Those grubs are real geniuses!
Radio check.
I got nothing.
Comms were sputtering back to life. Whatever was blocking the signal must have moved on.
Yeah.
to be out of there. What's next?
Well, we call in and make sure Control knows what's going on.
This grub, Goraznia, they called him Khan.
This isn't Goraznia.
My army threw all we have at him.
Colonel, what about the light mass missile?
Cadet, leave strategy to men with bars. I don't want to hear a word from any of you until Paddock's boogeyman is dead and I can...
Work.
It's classified, but there's one here in Halvo. The inventor teaches at the academy.
Yeah, Professor Elliot. I worked in his lab at LaCroix before he went military. The missile draws power from refined emulsion. The more emulsion, the bigger the boom.
Courtesy of your big boom.
God.
How close were you to the impact point?
Close enough. That thing would burn up this entire city.
This one's low yield. After the Hammer of Dawn, Elliot stopped working on it.
How low yield?
Baird, or Lieutenant. To fire that thing, you have to get the targeting beacon, the launch codes, personally activate the missile on site, and get this all approved by command.
Control, Kilo here. So, we're gonna get the light mass missile online and use it to kill General Khan. Any objections?
Works for me. All right, come on, Cadet. You're going back to the Academy. That's an order.
Cadet Hendrick, I'm curious to hear what it takes to convince an Onyx Guard cadet to steal one of the COG's most powerful weapons.
I was against it, sir.
That's right. Run to Danny.
Maybe you could show me and the army you volunteered for a little respect.
I tried that, and look what it got me.
Cadet?
Colonel. I'm an Academy cadet. I had to see if my friends were all right. We took the sewers from the museum to the Academy. The whole way there, I couldn't stop thinking about my fellow cadets. I hope they held out. Academy was overrun, but that beacon inside Professor Elliot's lab would allow us to land the light mass missile right on Karn's head. Whatever happened here, I know my fellow cadets fought hard.
There's no shame in losing a battle. Trust me,
I know.
It was a perfect combat situation for long-range weapons. Problem was, there weren't any.
To the rescue!
time to go inside, right?
Yeah. Find the light mass missile beacon, and then get the hell out of here.
My fellow cadets, we're the smartest, the toughest, the best the COG had to offer. The next generation of officers. Karn mowed them down like daisies.
Let's hope they didn't wreck Elliot's lab.
As long as the beacon's intact, we're okay.
Master was so worried about the UIR overrunning Halvo Bay that he installed a campus-wide gas-spraying dead man switch. Well, it had just gone off. We had to hurry.
Boomers!
Now, follow the signs for the SciTech Institute. No getting into the lab until you've cleared security. Unless you're a grub, then you just tunnel in. Something inside the lab set off the flame-away aerosol. I don't know what's in that stuff, but it didn't make for optimal soldiering.
Locust is dead! Every o'clock!
I have trouble!
Looks different from the last time I was here.
You worked here?
I helped test some prototype weapons. Professor Elliot had a crush on me.
Oh, okay. This has got to be it.
It's not moving.
Its restraints are still in place. There should be a button around here.
You're kidding me, right? That's our beacon?
These units are tough, durable, and they can cloak. You'll grow to love it. I thought he could cloak.
Not on Academy grounds. Anti-cloaking fields. We'll have to protect it on the way out.
Bot, can you take us out of here?
Yeah.
The bot was in charge. He knew the quickest way out. Was already pretty dinged up. We didn't know it yet, but a lot of nemesis were about to arrive. We were gonna have to give our all to protect it.
We gotta tell Level Boy back there he can move.
When the bot beeps and freezes, it means we've got company. He won't move till it's clear.
I think we all knew that, Cadet.
Actually, I didn't know that. Defend the beacon!
Sharpen your pencils and let's move. Bot, which way? What is it, little guy? Uh-huh. Something mean out there? Get ready to kill it!
spot was already pretty dinged up. We didn't know it yet, but a lot of Nemesis were about to arrive. We were gonna have to give our all to protect it. Beeps and freezes, it means we've got company. He won't move till it's clear.
I think we all knew that, Cadet.
Actually, I didn't know that.
Sharpen your pencils and let's move. Bot, which way?
Bot, help us out with the door.
What is it, little guy? Something mean out there? Get ready to kill it!
So hard for something that beeps so much.
Oh, they're coming in again. Get ready!
Hold tight!
Watch it!
To the run!
Get out!
It's back in protection mode, so protect it! I know I said this before, but that looks like all of them.
There, he can move.
Well, looky here.
I was beginning to wonder if that bot really knew the best way off campus. But with no one back at control to talk to, our only choice was to follow him.
Not your only choice, Cadet. You could have come home.
If you say so, sir. Rifles all ran dry, we switched to snub pistols.
We hear you, little guy. Hunker down and shields up. Kilo, protect the bot! Come on! This is my day!
Hurry!
courtyard on the way in. We're almost out of here. You made the final sacrifice.
Tripwire crossbow. Never seen one of these. Does this look kind of like a toy?
That's the raven we saw earlier, isn't it?
Yeah. Let's scavenge whatever equipment we can. That's all we can do now.
I couldn't understand it. Did you get any of that?
Loud and clear. Guns up!
There's some gear, near the wreckage at least. The animals the grubs have fighting for them aren't technically locusts. Not that that mattered. They wanted us just as dead as the grubs did.
Thank you.
There's gotta be more coming, Kilo. Stay sharp and set up. Guy.
Someone's gotta name this thing.
I followed Baird to the academy to find out what happened to my fellow cadets. I found out. They were all gone. The monster that killed them had to pay.
Are you here as Major Paddock of the UIR, or Private Paddock of the COG?
Whichever one you like less.
The Open Arms program may have given you our uniform, but you and I remain enemies.
Fine. Let's settle this like enemies, then.
Hey, that's enough!
Stand down. You Garaznis weren't known for treating prisoners very well. I'm sure you know nothing about it.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
You don't seem like a man who takes orders. Why even follow Baird?
You might say I had an ulterior motive.
You know what it's like to grow up poor, Colonel?
My father was a school teacher, Private, so yes, I do.
Then maybe you understand how curious a UIR soldier might be to see the fabled mansions of Alvo Bay. But I never imagined I'd see them like this.
The grubs tore this neighborhood apart.
Your professor lives up here? Are we sure he's still alive?
No, we are not.
We made it to Seahorse Hills without a bullet to spare. Lucky for us, we found some shotguns, which I can usually take or leave. Right now, I thought I'd take. We arrived out of ammo. Lucky for us, we found some rich fool's private armory, filled with gnashers and sawed-offs.
We need to keep moving. We have a long way to go to Elliot's house.
Are they bulletproof? Good to go!
I got a statue like that in my atrium.
You have an atrium.
More for me.
We needed to get the launch codes from this Professor Elliot. Baird and Sophia both said he was a decent man. Maybe he was. I tried to forget that his weapon burned off half my face.